I want to start off by saying happy Thanksgiving to anybody that celebrates it. I hope you enjoy it with your family today. And you're watching some Battlefield 4 Xbox One next-gen gameplay, 60 FPS, 64 players in multiplayer. This is sick. This is some squad team deathmatch because that's all I'm good at, just bare naked class setup. And this game really, really did take that next step when they put it on Xbox One. I mean, all the evolution we've talked about in the past, the small, the tropical storms, even down to small chimney collapsings on Zavod 311. This game is really, really cool. I'm enjoying it. I'm going to level up some classes. Definitely going to bring you some more objective gameplay. I got into the TDM just to get my feet wet on the Xbox One. So you guys enjoy that in the background. And we are going to knock out the top 20 worst video games. I did the top 20 best video games picked by you guys on Twitter. And you guys crushed 5,000 likes on that video in like 12 hours. So here it is. You guys enjoy. This is picked by you. Let's jump right into it. And if you guys enjoy being interactive on this and getting to help pick these, drop a like. Okay, at number 20 from BigCountry77X, he says, hashtag chaos top 20, NES Magic Johnson's basketball. He's actually referring to Magic Johnson's fast break. Totally right. This game was bad. A lot of these games you're going to see the cover art looks amazing, especially for the time and place when it was made back in the day. But when you get into the game, it's not even functional, and this was one of those. So it needed to be on the list. At number 19, from DeSayLan on Twitter, Farming Simulator 2012. Well, I put up the picture of Farming Simulator 2013 because it doesn't matter what year it is. If you're going to sit down and farm on a computer, something's wrong. I guess there's a simulator for everything, and some people would enjoy this, the farming enthusiasts out there, but this is not for me. This needs to be on the worst video game list. And that's why it's there. At number 18 from InVanBell2Mike, hashtag chaos top 20, Halo Wars. Halo didn't make many mistakes when it came to their franchise, but Halo Wars was definitely one of them. Just never took footing and never took off, and that's why it's on the list. At number 17 from Dominator FPS, Mario is missing for the Super NES. Most boring game I've ever played, chaos top 20. If you're going to take Mario out of the game, chances are it's going to fail. Just like Luigi's Mansion. Some people may have liked that, but you can't. Mario is the game. You can't take him out of the game. Luigi can't hang. It's all about Mario. Sorry. And number 16, from Sky3J on Twitter, Home Improvement the Game. Hashtag Chaos Top 20. I didn't even know this was a game. I love the show back in the day. Tim the Tool Man Taylor. But they'll make a video game out of anything. I'm pretty sure you go around chasing, trying to get power tools in this game, and it looks like it sucks. This looks like a game you would go buy, and you would turn it on for 30 seconds, you would shake your head, and then you would turn it back off. That's why it's on the list. At number 15, we're rocking right through these, Team Tricleft. Hashtag Chaos Top 20, Silver Surfer for NES. Once again, sick cover art on this game, but the game wasn't functional. It was bad. A lot of these games for NES, because it's so far back in the day and we're so far ahead in technology now, you would think they're not any good, but there are some that are good. But this one, when they're not functional and they just glitch out, you don't know the point of the game or what you're supposed to be doing, that's when they creep onto the worst video game list of all time. So that one deserved to be on there. At number 14 from Nolan Nick, Back to the Future. It was slow, had bad controls, and had nothing to do with the movie. Hashtag Chaos Top 20. It pains me to say this because Back to the Future, the trilogy, is one of my favorite trilogies and movies of all time. Love them. They bring back so many memories for me as a kid. But he's right. I've played this game in the past, and you wouldn't even think that the people that made the movies made the game because it really has nothing to do with the game. So it was a pretty crappy video game. And unfortunately, it needed to be on the list. At number 13, from This Is Fooge, The Walking Dead Survival Instinct. This one is another one that hurts because Daryl is awesome. You think if they're going to put Daryl as the main protagonist in a video game with his crossbow and his shotgun, it's going to rock. This one didn't. And so many people pre-ordered this on eBay at like $60, $70, $80 because of the hype factor. And it came out and it was horrible. Absolutely horrible. So, once again, it hurts, but it needs to be on the list. At Number 12. We're just sticking with this. I don't like putting these on here, but they have to be. From Outlaw the Cat, Mario 2. What were they thinking? You're right. They're like in this dream state. They were tripping off mushrooms or something, and they go into this weird dream world. Everything's wrong. You go from Mario 1, which is pretty basic, and then Mario 3, which is still in the Mario genre of things. Mario 2, it's like they went into psychedelic mode. It was weird. It wasn't right, and it really didn't fit. I know it's a classic, and I hold it dear to my heart like the others, but something was wrong with it. Something was wrong with the developer. Needed to be on the list. And number 11, Fast and Furious Showdown from BTG Brotherhood. One of the worst games ever made was probably Fast and Furious. It was really bad. I never played this. I'm going to take your word for it because it looks like it would be bad. It looks like awesome cover art. This is going to be bad. Let's get it. Woo! And it turns out to be actually bad. So there. Now let's crack into the top 10. Jacob Benavir says Naughty Bear was so bad, IGN scored the game 3 out of 10 on Xbox 360 and 2.5 out of 10 on PlayStation 3. Those are some bad numbers. I played this game. It looks cool. It's like, yeah, you get to be a teddy bear and hack things up, but when you get in it, the controls are horrible. You're right. The detection and everything on it's really bad. It sucked. It was a bad game. It was a good thought, but a bad game. On to number 9 from Mr. Carden on Twitter. Aliens Colonial Marines. Glitchiest game I've ever played. Chaos Top 20. I've never played this one, but a lot of people tweeted it at me, so I figured I needed to listen to the masses and throw it in the top 10 of the worst video games. That's why it's there. Same with the next one. At number 8 from TEC Red Devil, Brink. I remember the hype behind this game. This was going to be a game changer when it came to FPS. I believe it's an FPS game. I never played it. And it turned out it was bad. It's so funny because games either go straight up or they go straight down. And this one went straight down. At number 7 from Caliber FT. Nice name, Caliber. I like it. Tomb Raider the original. Hashtag Chaos Top 20. Once again, classic franchise. You can't go wrong with Tomb Raider. But the original was really, really hard to play. It was confusing. And it didn't really work right. Depending on what you played it on, whether that be PC or Sega Saturn, I believe, or I don't even remember what games it came out or what consoles it was on, but it was hard to play. I remember that. So it needed to be on the list. Sorry, I know. At number 6, from Professor Griswold, White Men Can't Jump, the game most people have never heard of, and it was pretty much broken. The movie was insane. The movie was great. I did play this game when I was a kid, and sometimes you couldn't even dribble the ball. It wouldn't even allow you to dribble the ball. You just float across the court. So it was a broken game. At number 5, this one hurts, from Infinite Icon, Duke Nukem Forever, the game that took 10 years to come out, and the cover art was great, the trailers were great, everything was amazing, and then the game was lackluster. That's it. Disappointed. Needed to be in the top 5 worst video games. You guys may disagree. I don't know, but yeah. At number 4, another one from Kyler YouTube. Homefront. Massive flop. One of the biggest FPS flops I've ever seen. I remember Machinima pushing the crap out of this game. This was going to be the COD killer. This was it. I remember some YouTubers that actually said they were going to go straight to this, and their channels kind of just faded away. Yeah. Homefront was bad. At number 3, we have Bumutri. Superman for Nintendo 64, probably the worst game I've ever played. I actually threw up the Superman NES because it was bad too, so I'm going to take your word that the one for Nintendo 64 was just as bad. At number 2, from OZ013 Magdaleno, Hannah Montana on 360. Anything Hannah Montana, Miley Cyrus in a video game is going to suck and be deserving of the number 2 spot on the list. There you go. And at number 1, the worst video game of all time, picked by you, I Am Slenderman, says E.T. the Extraterrestrial Atari 2600 Chaos Top 20. I owned this game. This game was confusing as hell. You were supposed to walk around and get parts to a phone, but it never worked that way. I don't think the game was beatable. I think they trolled you into thinking you could beat it, and you couldn't. Horrible game. I implore you to go pick up an Atari and try to play this game. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Drop a like. Be thankful for what you have in life today, and I'll see you later.